starting in Newcastle, but I'm going to use in Circle. Okay, first time I'm here. Let's go first time to spend the battle. But anyways, we have a new Darman's unit, Green Gavarina. And that's just currently available on the raid update. I just logged into the game, and also we reached the first milestone campaign for the Infernal Showdown on Vortex Arena. Now, I rallied into this already, and so I'll go a little bit quick here. She's a run-on unit, and she said to me, I thought she's going to be leaning on the defensive side due to the fact that her defense is slightly higher than her mass attack. Umbrella, 60% boost to defense, recovery, and max HP, 80% boost to defense and recovery when BD gauge is over 50%, boost to BD gauge by 10 DCs every turn, and damage taken, and boost to BD gauge by 47 DC. Crystalline River, this will require 20 DC, and it's a 14 hit combo, so 1 hit equals 1 DC. Now, she can negate critical damage, and damage taken will boost the BD gauge 5 to 8 BCs for 3 turns, so it's slightly better than the leader skill's abilities. That is, it will give a 35% boost to BC Brave Crystal and Heart Crystal drop rates for 3 turns, and 2 turn mitigation. That's pretty interesting. So, from what I could tell, she is a BB gauge age boosting mitigator, which is pretty good. Torrential Tribute is slightly different. It adds on 13 more hits, 200% more to the multiplier. However, it negates elemental damage instead of critical damage. So that's the interesting thing. You can alternate between this. And also since the Super Brave Burst requires 25 BCs for the rest of the Brave Burst. This will total out to be 53 BC. So yeah, a little bit heavy on the fill, but shouldn't be that bad given her abilities. And let's see. She still has the damage taken boost being raised to 5 to 8 BC for 3 turns. So that's good. 50% boost to the Brave Burst. Burst gauge fill rate for 3 turns. Okay, that's another good add-on. Oh! Look at this. Boost Brave Burst gauge by 12 BC for 1 turn. Also the 2-turn mitigation. So yeah, she is a Brave Burst gauge filling unit, but she's also a mitigator. Pretty interesting, to be honest. Compassion Cascade. Now this is going to be a little bit more advantageous. 32 BCs, and it can generate up to 31, meaning it would be she can get back her Brave Burst, but just not her Super Brave Burst, but it fills out a majority of it. So let's see, you have a 1,100% multiplier, okay, we can see that first. Damage taken, boost BD gauge by 50 BC for 3 turns, that's kind of an insane amount of damage. Boost to recovery. Recovery is not that important as much unless you're looking to boost HP recovery of your units. But recovery is not really an important stat. 300% boost to attack and defense relative to recovery for 3 turns. Ah, okay. That's actually a good buff to be honest. So that's why you gain the recovery buff, because it goes in tandem with the attack and defense rather than the recovery buff. Now let's see. Bubble Mastering adds stats stats and removal effect to BD, 4,000 HP water barrier to BD SPD, so you have keep that time, right? And 25% boost to defense and hit recovery of water types. Ah, so her extra skill is more suited to Amano Water Squad this way. Kind of interesting, really. But then again, and you can use her on a Rainbow Squad as well. Since she has a Body Burst Gauge. What the? No, not again! I am dreadfully sorry about that. Oh my goodness. Just as this video is going by pretty well, the game glitches on me again. Lately, I've been noticing that my screen starts to flicker, like from a black screen to a normal screen. And it's kind of getting ridiculous how often this happens. My Wi-Fi is good. I understand why this happens. And it is currently, as you can see, 10:17. Now, it's going to only take my shower after doing a couple of things, but it's nah. Also, I think we are getting the water vortex again now at some point. I forgot what day it was again. But, for the most part, I think that radiator unit that you guys just saw, she should be able to come on the human. Back to the movies. And by the way, the temporary arena details are a little bit lovely. I'll show you the word summoned it shortly. But back to this. So she can remove stats elements. However, she does not have a stats element for negation. And so far, there's three options. The water barrier is pretty weak, only 4,000 HP. Then again, upgrading it may be a good option. Anyways, let's go on to the SPs. Skill point. 30% boost to all parameters. That's always a good effect right there. You want to make sure you boost the parameters of your army units. Damage taken boost. This is a weak one right here. Yeah, so that third option isn't going to be good. Oh! Allows the SPVs use elemental damage negation and elemental weakness damage negation to last for 2 turns. And also says adds its elemental negation to 2 turns for BB. Ah! I see here. Like, these are just a strength things for upping the negations of critical damage and elemental damage. And this gives both effects to PD and SPD. This way she can use them in the now what. This way you don't have to constantly switch back and forth like, do you use the PD or the SPD? You want to switch back and forth for the mitigation. This, hold up, adds a great restoration effect to the SPD, so first here, but the one below it adds a 15% chance to resist a 1 KO attack and restores 50% HP effect to BBSBB. This sounds kind of powerful here. It's a 15% chance, which is pretty low, but pretty useful. And the other effect adds an 80% chance to resist a 1 KO and restores all HP via UV. She's a good healer right there. I mean, let me see here. If you want to get all the negations, problem with that. It looks what? Well, then again, you're in that third, like, that first 30 S-class, and you, the first year, because you can develop another unit. But, the second and last options are pretty great. However, they would cost you 60 in total. And if you wanted to get all the other negation abilities, that would cost you 40. However, Omni plusing with +3, you'll be able to get that parameter boost. So, she's a good healer unit. Or a good mitigator. She can help boost a blade burst stage. She can help with removing staff ailments. She can negate critical damage. She can negate elemental damage. Plus, if you get her SP options, she'll be able to help your party resist a one-hit KO attack. However, the BDS speed in trigger is very low, as it only does a 15% block. UBB is your better choice. However, the burst heal effect acts as the second part for the BD resist the 15% chance KO. HP, meaning if your boy is like about getting close average down to the health, you can recover half of that. If you have any other burst healing units, this can help. So all in all, a clean Bevelina is a pretty good mitigator. For those who are looking to get her, you can give it a try with her. However, don't expect to immediately get her. Because let's have a look at the World Summer Gate, shall we? Let's see. Welcome to the second unit of the Batman series, Gavelina. She washes away your enemies with the true power of water. Or it just helps defend your party better. Now, of course, with these rate-up summons, 5 gems and 1 summon ticket, each summon guarantees you a 5-star unit, and you pull your stash match with a chance to get a 7-star potential unit, and also the badges from pull your stash match over up to gear badge, meaning you do have a chance of getting solo. Also, I did get my summon ticket this morning as the 8-21st day of login by Phelan came out from the day. Yeah, that sucked. Even though I have Phelan already, I didn't even need it. Can I just get lucky and get a full Omni unit? Remember? I'd say at least maybe one or two people pull an Omni unit from the Omni Plus Summer Gate. Anyways, let me go on with this so I don't drown things out. Of course, there are global exclusives, but no collaboration or limited edition units. Now, Gasolina is a limited edition unit as well, so once it goes gone, she may not be available ever again. But who knows? Maybe her and Nakalana should come back as a re-summon gate like Arthur and Lancelot did. And if they do, you bet I'm gonna try that. So I'm gonna have to be saving my summon tickets for a while. The rate-ups promotion. Okay, so in order to get the temple rate-ups, you have to do 9 summons. Now, I only have my blades already used for 15 summons, so I'm not gonna get greedy. I believe she comes out to be a Omni unit and such stuff. Nagalana did. Yeah. Also, there is a bonus random elegant figure from 5 stars to 7 stars. There's a list here, but we really wouldn't fix it. Now, there are bundles as well that you can get them. Also, there's an Algora channel, but I'm not too many Algoras. unfortunately, you won't be able to see them, but I can at least probably describe a couple of them. Let's see, Combat Tempest. This will add an extra hit to the normal attack. Good for a unit like... Zeku, yes, for the unit of Colosseum. This way you can do 2 hits at once. Divine Oracle level 3, this will give you 20% boost up to all parameters. Warrior's Authority and Guard. Let's see, Warrior's Authority, I think that gives a boost to defense and HP, defense and attack by a certain amount depending on the level. Guardian's Authority, boost to attack. Boost to defense and HP. Destroyer's Authority, boost to attack and HP. Vitality increases health, Tumble Protection increases defense, and Tumble Rune increases attack. Now, I believe the level 5 runes give you a 50% boost to those attacks. That's a very level 6. Warrior's Command, Treasure Abode, and Thief Warning. I think Treasure Abode and Thief Warning will help boost to drop rates of particular things. Tail of Honor just boosts your D gauge further, but it's not very useful. Extra skills of 7 stars. Legendary Thief. That's always helpful for a Zell Knight. If you have 2 Zell Knights, you can equip Legendary Thief to one of them. So this way you get a drop rate boost to, I believe, Zell Karma items. Thief Warning 2. Demonic Victory. I think it boosts this way. Each turn or one different enemies. Not very good. And most of the others, I have no idea what they are. So yeah, those units are out. You can get them. For me, I am not gonna really be saying for them, but hey. Also, while we're on this video, let's go back to the Fire Vortex arena. Okay, this has been a lot of we'll be seeing a lot of Blaze leads on here. And it's not Blaze, either Akurai leads or any other one, I think. Well, that's Blaze, so I'm really cool. And that was just a lead for Glenn as well, as you were very much called Team Leader. The Polar has an Angel Idol? Probably a sphere he has. I don't think he's got an angel out of him now, but I'm not seeing an angel out of him. Yeah, I'm slowly climbing up the rankings. I am facing more tougher opponents because in order for me to really get into the high rankings, I am going to put some of these into the gym and that would be strong to me. But strong, people get strong as well. And also, if you're wondering what kind of strong is for the steel ones and the extra steel ones, I will show you if you have a strong for the steel ones. Of course, the Blaze gets to the end of it, but of course, I'm going to the last one. So, the Blaze is maybe. Let's see here. Oh, he doesn't have the Blaze on the screen. I think he's a mini-stop. body off and make them closer. And also, I want to know if they reduce the amount of time to cool down to 5 seconds. So let's go down here, because 10% is a loaded cool down. You'll be seeing a lot of people with no losses. And also, people think there are some people think that boost to attack, and it helps several people to attack the enemies, making them a bit more bulky. And then my friend, boost to HP, and also getting an increased HP reference effect, which will just see HP regen to take damage. And if you switch the success rate of the we'll be right back.
Fun.